I don't know what to do with it all.
Are you settled yet? Are you, what are you and the family doing right now?
Well, I'm settled into the Georgia Center over there, okay. A block away. So yeah, it's been good. You know, coming in as a new staff, new defensive staff, we're spending a ton of time up here, obviously, and so it's been really good. My family's still back in L.A., and we just bought a house the other day, and it's kind of neat. The biggest thing we're looking for in buying a home, my wife and I have four kids, and ranging from our oldest is a boy, 13, and then three little girls. 12, 10, and 6. So we wanted a place where we could really settle in and there are kids everywhere. It's where we live right now in California. It's one of the most beautiful places probably in the world. But there's not a kid around it than probably 3 or 4 blocks. And so we can't wait to get moved and really get around and raise our family with a little bit of a little bit more normal setting instead of 33 million people.
I mean, coaching can be such a transient profession, as you've seen. But you have bought a house here and ready to...
Yeah, I bought a, they're going to have to take me out of here at gunpoint. I mean, this is where I want to be. And the people that I'm working with, I've worked 12 years in this profession. And I left the University of Nebraska because I really felt like I needed, I was kind of a sprint. I wanted to be head coach, I wanted to go be defensive coordinator, make that next move, and so on and so forth. And you know what? I've gotten to the point right now where I say it very humbly, but I want to be the best linebacker coach in football. And that's where my focus is. And I want to be at a university like the University of Georgia and work for great people. And Coach Rick, if there's a finer human being coaching this game, I haven't met him. And, working with Jeremy Pruitt, that guy, he reminds me of someone I played for and coached with starting out. He reminds me a lot of Bob Stoops. I mean, he's got some amazing qualities, a tremendous leader, very focused, knows exactly what he's looking for, and he has no ego. And the reason he doesn't have an ego is because he's a great teacher. And he's very confident in what he believes in, and he knows what it takes to get there. So we're all buying houses there. That's where we want to be.
Did you end up in Oconee County or Athens, Florida?
Yes, sir.
Oconee County.
Yeah, I think we're in there with a couple blocks away from Coach Pruitt and Coach Friend and Coach Bobo.
Okay.
So.
I think Coach Rick had said that some of the coaches had to look at bios maybe from the media guide during match drills. In terms of to know their players, are you getting a handle on those guys?
Yeah, that would be me. I was one of those guys. But, yeah, it takes a little bit of time. We're trying to get our hands wrapped around the recruiting part, so know every young man in the state of Georgia. That's where we're going to kill it in the state of Georgia. And we're also trying to obviously, learn get to know our players. And that it takes a little bit of time. So I know my position guys right now, and I'm branching out from there.
It's a little bit confusing the way the responsibilities are in. Can you explain what you understand is to be your role in special teams and linebackers?
Well, I think in general that what Coach wanted to do is he wanted to have an offensive emphasis on special teams and defensive emphasis. And one of my responsibilities is to head up the defensive part of that. But it's a collective unit or collective responsibility. We're all going to be involved. I mean, I'm going to be coaching on every single unit, and Coach Scher is going to be coaching on every single unit, and a lot of us are. So we may be heading it up and pointing it in the right direction, but we're all going to have our hands on it, and we'll play well.